church that are doing a film noir, Jonah and the Whales, play here. So I hope you'll enjoy and clap and celebrate all of their hard work. I should really quick recognize Senora V, our Spanish teacher, is also a master of technology, which I am not. So you might see some of her handiwork through this play if we can get it to work. Okay, some prayers right now. That would be great. So we are going to turn it over to our third grade.
Trouble. Maybe we could help find him, you know, investigate with him and his friends. Oh, right. Like adults are gonna talk to us.
No, we'll talk to the kids around here.
Great idea. Kids hear everything.
So we might be able to look in. We still join them, but first we need to round up the usual suspects.
I'll keep busy. I need answers. The search led to a shabby warehouse. Quite some damage around the poor old job.
And Hector, come over here a minute. I know lots of the doc workers at the Yak family inn's house. Did anything unusual happen lately?
The other day, I was helping my mother serve up the stew, and this weird-looking old man sat down at the table, raving about how God told him to go to Nineveh and preach to the people over there.
So that's where he is.
No, he said it wasn't good. He said he didn't like the Ninevites. I was afraid if he preached, they'd repent and God would save them.
I thought that was the way it was supposed to work.
I don't know.
The Ninevites are Gentiles. They're not like God. They're enemies. Maybe that's why Jonah didn't want God to save them.
So if Jonah didn't go to Nineveh, where did he go?
He got on a ship going to Tarshish.
Now that's important because Nineveh's to the east and Tarshish is to the west.
I can tell you one thing. That guy was running from God as fast as he could.
Thank you.
right?
Not exactly.
We looked over the side of the boat and saw this great big dark shadow. I knew it was as big as the boat. Then Jonah disappeared from the sea. It's like the sea just swallowed him up. And when the storm ended and the sun came out.
So you and the crew were the last ones to see Jonah alive?
I guess so.
Well, thanks for that information. Jonah drowned. No crime was committed. It's lamenting when you have eliminated the impossible, but it remains how improbable must be the truth.
What?
Okay, mister, who are you? What's the last thing you remember? And why do you smell like this?
It'll go easy if you come clean now.
Okay. My name is Jonah. God told me to go to Nineveh, but I went to Tarshish instead.
We already know that.
I was on this boat and there was a storm. They cast lots and I knew it was my God who caused the storm. So I told the group to throw me overboard.
We know that too.
What we want to know is exactly what happened once you fell in the sea. Details, we need details.
There are some stories a man needs to keep to himself. Stories so bizarre, no one can believe them.
Rumbling in my stomach, I couldn't handle it anymore, so I threw him up.
and I have learned my lesson from now. No matter how hungry I get, from now on, no more prophets for me.
So thanks to the big fish you ended up on the beach. Where have you been since then?
I went to Nineveh, I preached, and they repented. End of story.
Not so fast. Tell me what happened next.
Don't listen to him. He's just a
I went for a small, elongated, non-hairy, soft-bodied animal. Santa for short.
What do you know about this?
Let's see. Jonah preached all right. When Nineveh repented, he just sat in the shade of a glorified, and God sent me to cut it down. And he just sat there, pouted. Pouted? Presidents aren't supposed to pout. I'm just telling you what happened. So there you have it, the tale of a man caught in the whirlpool of circles. Narrow-minded, judgmental, pity, epic, and another.
Thank you.